Hey you guys, what's happening? I'm coming to you to share a product with you guys. Yes. Okay, first I'm gonna give y'all a 360 for the hair. Wait, is that okay? Yeah. My dog's hair gets everywhere. Sorry. I was like rolling around. You know, sometimes you gotta be a tomboy, you know. What the hell? Get out. Okay, now the reason why I'm giving y'all this long-ass 360 slow motion turn is because I noticed sometimes when people do natural hair videos that you don't really get a chance to see their hair. And I know my camera isn't the best, so I'm trying my best to give y'all a real, you know, look, see, at my hair. Now, this is a braid out, okay? Now, if you watch my previous video, you know that I just got my hair cut. My mom cut my hair. Yes, she's a beast on these scissors. Okay, and I told her I wanted this little cut, and this is what she did for me. So when I originally did my hair, I used all Cream of Nature products. My hair came out looking good, and I want to explain this. The first day, it did feel moisturized, but by the second day, I didn't like how my hair felt. It felt easily breakable, if that makes sense. So I decided, after watching my girl AE, African Export, blogspot.com, okay, Benicia, I love that her name is Benicia, anyway, she did a Bantu knot out on her blown out hair, and it was gorgeous. It was, I mean, you know, African Export hair is at least down to her mid back. So her hair was really long, and I mean, the hair was so shiny and smooth looking. It just gave me all kinds of life. So, me having this already and keeping this on deck, I keep this on deck, but I only used to use it on my edges. My weave styles will always tell me it will, you know, have your edges laid, but you know, you put it on your tight hair now and it won't be hard like a gel, and it's not. So that's what I always use it for. But since I saw African Export put it on all of her hair, I figured why not try it. So last night when I was rebraiding my hair, and I want to explain this to new naturals, because my friend Christine just left and she's not a new natural, but she's a natural that never really learned what to do with her grain of hair, because our hair is similar. The things that I know, I try to help her with. Like, I just plaited up her whole head using some Suave leave-in and the foam from that foam wrap from Cream of Nature, because I do like that foam and I do think it's very defining and it leaves your hair looking very beautiful once it's dried all the way. But I do feel like it doesn't give, all of those products together to me don't do as much satisfaction as probably this moisturizer or my Suave Naturals and then the foam on top. The foam wrap on top. So I do like that. I do like that foam wrap for my definition, but I feel like I need more of a moisturizer on under it. So that's what I did with her hair. And I took out a little bit of it. It was a little dry. So I took out a little bit of it to show her how to separate her hair once these braids are dry. Because a lot of the times, this is something I didn't know, how to properly fluff out your hair after you've taken your braids out. Because sometimes with hair like mine, you go too far and it becomes a big old throwy mess and not as defined as you may have wanted it. So I was explaining to her that you have to be careful not to disturb the curl. Yes, you're going to get some, you know, little frizziness every now and again. But for the most part, you're going to get a defined look if, first of all, you have the right products. You've combed through your hair before twisting or braiding. and you know, you're giving your hair a chance to dry completely and you can pull apart properly. Now I explained to her that when she pulls her plaits apart, like I'm, you know, my hair is not plaited now, so you know I can't really show you, but I'm gonna tell you, and in another video I'll probably show you. But basically, like, you know, I used just this in some water to replait my hair last night. And hold up, let me. Okay, first of all, I got this from Sally. People ask how much this is. $7.99. That's how much I paid for it. You can find this at a Walgreens. You can find this at any probably hair store. You can probably find this at Sally's. It smells really, really good, and it's a thick, like moisturizing feel to it, and it feels kind of oily. So I think this is a water-based product too. And it probably does have silicones in it. So if you're on that, you know, all natural products thing, this is not for you. Me, on the other hand, I just kind of work with whatever works for my hair. And I love the way my hair came out with this olive oil mango butter moisturizer. Okay? This is basically the result of that. And this is all day hair. Okay? And my hair has been like this all day. All day. And I have been thong in here all day. I have been shaking and moving, turning around quickly and moving, and then getting it out of my face. I've been acting a fool with this here hair. And that's because it's light enough that when my hair is moving, like I have body, but it's still moisturized. It doesn't feel like it'll break easily. It feels good, it smells good, and it's defined. This is because of this. I love this. I personally don't feel like I'll probably buy any other type of moisturizer. This is it for moi. I love this, okay? Especially since this has always been a staple product, using it for a different reason. Now, what I was saying about the pulling the hair apart. For instance, depending on the size of your plaits and or twist, please make sure your hair is completely dry. Because if your hair is not completely dry, it will frizz once you've taken your hair apart. So if you have to sit in the dryer for a little while, if you prefer not to do that, wait the entire time it takes for your hair to dry. Know that in braids, it's going to take longer for your hair to dry than in twists, okay? Because twists are, you know, not that, you know, much binding. It's just twisted. Whereas braiding is more hair tied together, so it's more hair being, you know, put together, so it's harder for the air to reach you. So I set in the dryer, excuse me for a minute. What the fuck? Anyway, people bring out the ignorant New Orleans girl in me, you know what I mean? Like, when you know the voice gets high pitch. Yeah, okay. I try to keep that to a minimum. Put some bass in my voice so not to, you know, annoy the enemies. Anyway, but that's how you gotta talk to him. Bruh, come here. Cause it turns me on up when nervous. Just let me show you how to touch me. I could teach you. Yeah. Okay. Now. Okay, so when I say what I would advise for pulling apart your braids or twists is to unplait or untwist them first, your entire head. Give your hair a chance to set, and then pull them apart once you finish unbraiding or untwisting your entire head, and then pull them apart so you can have a full look at it. Because sometimes if you start to pull them apart before you've seen your entire head, you can go a little bit too far and things start to get frizzy. So, you know, I advise against doing that. I believe that you should give your hair a chance to set because it gives you the best results. Now, you should also remember to part your hair when you do your plaits or twists, to part your hair like you want your hair to lay. And so I had to tell my girl, you know, she was like, you know, because when I plaited her hair, I gave her her side part like she always likes, and her braids were laying in the way that I want her hair to lay once she takes it out, okay? So, you know, I'm just kind of giving y'all some tips on a braid out. Another tip for the braid out. Sometimes your hair can be different lengths when you get to the ends. So you might have three pieces if you're doing plaits, and like one piece will be too small. You would join the pieces and twist them at the ends. That's what I do on a lot of my, you know, on my pieces. Once I braided it to the ends as far as I can go, I will twist it comb the ends with a rat tail comb and create my curl and just curl it with my fingers and leave it as is. Now, if you're transitioning, your hair may not do this on the ends, and then that instance, I would say get you some curl rods. Curl rods, wrap them around, get them good and tight on there, put your satin bonnet on, wake up, braid out, twist out, stick, okay? Stick. As long as your hair is dry, stick. Good products, stick. You combed it all the way through, stick. So, that is my advice on a braid out. Now, when I took my hair out this morning, because this is so moisturizing and has olive oil already in it, I did not need to add anything to my hair when I was taking my braids out. Now, I, out of habit, put some shea oil. Let me see. I have like this little sample of shea oil that I've had for the longest time. So I'll like just put this in my hands because it's really thick. It's a really thick serum. And like, you know, take my plaits out and then, you know, I'm bomb, bomb, bomb. But for girls with coarser hair, like if you're like me, I'm a 4A, 4B, something like that. I don't know. But I mean, if your hair look like this after a good braid out, that means you might have similar hair to my own. And if that is the case, castor oil is a beast. Castor oil is a beast. Don't overuse it, but it can add the most succulent moisture to coarse hair. It, to me, it's better. It does better on my hair than coconut oil and olive oil. But right now, all I have is olive oil, so that's what I'm using. It does dry. But I'm just saying, like, when your hair is feeling extra dry or for deep conditioning, I would say, girls, please try your castor oil. If you have really, really coarse, thick hair, try your castor oil, honey. So, I'm trying to think. Oh, yeah. Okay. So, also, my friend is going out of town, and she asked about beach-ready natural hair for a person like herself that doesn't like to always have to re-braid her hair. Now, her hair is rather long. Her hair is much longer than mine. It's actually, I think, past her shoulders now. So, what I would say, what I told her to do, is the night before she leaves to go on her trip, wash her hair, detangle her hair, and as she's detangling, put her Suave leave-in conditioner. Put that, I mean, well, not, it's not a leave-in, it's a regular conditioner. It's the Suave with almonds. That's what the kind that I use. Let me see, because I have the shampoo down here, and it looks the same. Okay, see like this? I've shown this in previous videos. This is the shampoo, and that's because I told y'all I accidentally bought this, but I'm not about to throw it away because I'm sure if the conditioner is good, the shampoo will do me just as good when I need something to really shampoo my hair and clarify my hair. I don't shampoo often, but because of the way products build up, I tend to, you know, if I have to shampoo, I shampoo. I'm not completely against shampooing, especially if the shampoo doesn't make my hair feel stripped, because sometimes shampoo makes your hair feel stripped, and that's, you know, the reason why a lot of curly girls don't like to use it. But not every shampoo does that. So, this is the brand of conditioner that I use, and I will use it for my cold washes. And then when I'm ready to style my hair, I'll put that on my hair too. And then I would suggest using this on top and then an oil to seal your ends. And I told her just to do twists, chunky twists, all over her head. And in the morning, take her twist out and push her, and either she can have her hair out like she wants to, and then when she's about to go to the beach or whatever, go swimming, whatever she's gonna do, take her hair and put it up into a high, you know, a high pony or a high puff, whichever you want to call it. But you know, get yourself a good band and bring it all the way up, okay? Tie your edges down, and that way either you can wear your hair that way, or you can take it down and just spray your hair with some water and fluff it out, shake it, and let it fall. You know, a lot of girls don't know that when you pineapple your hair, depending on the type of hair that you have, it doesn't always mean that your hair is going to just look ready as soon as you take it down. You have to spray it, you know, a little bit. Don't completely wet your hair, but give your hair a chance to get its groove back so it can lay back down. You know what I mean? Especially if it's already stretched out, it will fall after you've given it a little time. Like about 20 minutes, you know, like, you know, do your hair, get dressed, put your makeup on, and give your hair a chance to fall. You know what I mean? So that was my advice to her, to either keep her hair up in a puff and just have a, you know, put something on her edges at night and tie her hair down. And it will keep her hair in a form that she can style it without it being an issue, without her having to detangle all over again. Because she has a thick head of hair, honey. And she don't feel like doing it all the time. So I told her you just have to style your hair at that beginning in a way that will give you versatility for the rest of the week. Which is twisting your hair, you can wear it out, or you put it up in a puff. Remember when you go to sleep at night to put your hair up so it stays stretched and doesn't begin to mat and curl on top of it. And also remember to tie your edges down if you want that smooth sleep look. With natural hair, when we sleep on our hair and we don't have anything to tie our edges down, even if you're sleeping with a satin bonnet on, your edges aren't gonna do anything but curl back up because that's the closest part to your head. At night, you sweat when you have a satin bonnet. It keeps a little bit of moisture in your hair. So that's why I would tell girls when you go to sleep on soaking wet hair, don't do that. Don't do that because your hair's not gonna be dry when you wake up. It's just not. You know, if you go to sleep on soaking wet hair with like a satin bonnet on, your hair's not going to dry completely. Also, taking braid outs. You guys, remember that you have plaits. So there are parts in your head. When you take out your hair and you fluff out your hair, do not forget your roots. Now, what I mean by this is don't go in there and disturb the curl and just put your hand in and all this. No, don't do that. Don't do that. Go through your hair where you feel your holes. Do like a little scratching motion, but do not use your nails, tips of your fingers. You don't want to scratch your scalp. It, you know, fucks up your hair growth. You want to just shake, see, like this, in this motion, in a circular motion. You know what I mean? You want to make sure you get, you know, your pieces in a, you know, your spaces in the back. And then you want to shake your hair out and bam, it's going to give you life. Alright. I'm tired. So I think that's everything I wanted to say. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. I hope it was informative. This was like especially for my girl, so she could just have some guidelines on what to do with her hair. But for every other natural girl out there and all those that follow me that wanted some tips, even our, you know, transitioners. Just some natural hair tips. So I hope you guys enjoyed this video. Like, comment, and subscribe. Share me on your Twitter, your Facebook, and your Tumblr. Don't forget my other channel, Bondi Blue, where I have all of the TV shows and all of the latest gossip in this bitch. Yes, I'll be making more Ish Talking videos and MF and Advice videos because I know most of y'all on here know me over there, okay? So, come back, share me. I love you guys. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.